With the improvement in power factor, we can save the cost of conductor. We can reduce the electricity bill. Also, we can make our system more efficient. Improving power factor and keeping it near to unity leads to many advantages, both technically and economically. But the question is, how we can do that? How we can improve power factor? Well, if you want to get the answers, you need to watch the video. If you are looking for a video about different ways of improving power factor, then this video is not for you. In this video, we'll be looking at very basic how you can improve the power factor and the ways to do it that we will see in our next video of power factor series. Before getting further in this video, I will strongly recommend you to watch previous videos of power factor series. You'll get link for those videos down in the description. So let's get started with how you can improve power factor. Let's say I have a zero and I want to keep that zero constant, but someone added positive 7 in it and now my number is changed to positive 7. So to get my original number again, what I have to do? I hope you have guessed it right. Yes, I have to add equal and opposite number with it. So I added negative 7 and I got my original number back, that is 0. Well, if you understood this simple math, you have understood the concept of how you can improve power factor. Now, I only need to explain the concept, and for that, stick to the video. Now, if your system's total impedance is equal to total resistance, then it means that your power factor is good and no reactive power is consumed. But as soon as you add load to it, the load most of the time is inductive. Your total impedance is no longer equal to your total resistance, which means that you are consuming reactive power and the power factor is poor. Now, how to get back to your original position, that is total resistance equals to total impedance? You have to add equal and opposite amount of reactive power to the system. Yes, it is as simple as that. So what kills inductive reactance? Yes, capacitive reactance. So you have to add equal and opposite amount of capacitive reactance in the circuit. The effect of these two equal and opposing reactance, that is inductive and capacitive, will bring the circuit's total impedance equals to total resistance. Consider the example shown to understand more clearly. Consider that we have a 230 volt AC supply connected to a load as shown. Current flowing through the circuit is 1.91 amps. The active power in the circuit is 218.8 watts. Reactive power is also 218.8 VAR and the apparent power is 309 volt ampere. So if we calculate power factor of this circuit, we get power factor equals to 0.7. Now, to improve the power factor of this circuit, we need to inject equal and opposite amount of reactive power in it. As the reactive power is inductive, we'll add a capacitor in parallel with the load. Now let's see what this capacitor will do with our circuit. With the addition of capacitor, the total impedance of the circuit is reduced to almost 61 ohms, which was 84.85 in previous case. And hence, the apparent power will now change to 222.53 volt ampere. And now, if we calculate the power factor, we'll get power factor equal to 0.98. So let's understand what has happened here. The power triangle shows the different types of power in the circuit without capacitor. Here we can see the inductive reactive power is 218.8 VAR. So if we need to improve the power factor of the circuit, we need to add equal and opposite amount of reactive power. So we added a capacitor. Reactive power we are getting from capacitor is, let's say, X VAR. So This positive and negative power will cancel out each other, and the resultant power triangle will look like this. 218.8 VAR minus X VAR reactive power now remains in the circuit, and which has caused improvement in power factor. Now, what are the different ways you can use to improve power factor that we will see in our next video of power factor series. If your circuit is predominantly inductive, then the power factor of the circuit is lagging, as the current in case of inductive load lags behind the voltage. Similarly, if the load is capacitive, then the power factor of the circuit is leading, as the current leads the voltage in case of capacitive load. So I hope you guys have understood the very basic of how you can actually improve power factor. You can subscribe to my YouTube channel to get the future update. That's all for this video. I'll see you guys in the next one. Till then, you can keep watching, keep learning.